Hello! Welcome to a different kind of video than normal, but one that I am very excited to make. This is my bullet journal for 2019. Wow, this is really awkward to film this way. This is my third bullet journal. I had one back in 2017 that I started over the summer, and then one last year that I started at the beginning of the year. But bullet journals normally only work for me during breaks that I have off. Basically times where I don't have the structure of school and a class schedule, because normally for that kind of stuff, I use my calendar on my laptop to plan out my day. But I recently watched Cattytastic's 2019 bullet journal, and I absolutely loved some of the spreads that she did. I thought that they were very useful, and I kind of realized where I've been going wrong in bullet journals in the past. So I decided to give it another shot this year, do another 2019 bullet journal, and hopefully fix some of the problems that I had before and have this be super useful for me. This journal is an Exceed journal, which is only like $6 at Walmart. It's the same kind of journal that I used last year, and I really liked it, so I just got it again because it's cheap. None of my stuff ever bled through, which is great. And then the pen that I'm going to be using is just a Sharpie felt tip pen. Nothing too fancy because I'm cheap and I don't want to spend a ton of time decorating, so I'm just gonna be using black pen for pretty much everything. So for this first page, I just have like 2019 title page, simple. That's about it. Next is just a simple index spread. I normally don't use the index that often. I like normally will start using it and then halfway through the year just like forget it exists. But I think with the way that I'm trying to do this bullet journal, it'll come in handy. If not, it's only two pages wasted, so either way, I figured might as well just have it, just in case I actually do want to use it later on. Next, we have the future log, which, of course, is always the absolute worst spread to make of all time. All of these tiny little numbers are so hard to write, and my hand cramped up so many times while making this spread. But despite that, it does come in handy throughout the year. Whenever you have something coming up that isn't in the month that you're currently in and you have to write it down so that you know what's going on later in the year. I also like to use this for holidays and birthdays just to note when things are throughout the year so I can see what's coming up. And whenever I do make the monthly spread, I can just transfer everyone's birthdays onto that. So even though it takes frickin' forever and I hate it so much, the future log is definitely something that comes in handy. Now this page is obviously pretty blank. What actually happened was I meant to have my 2019 goals on this page right after the future log. But whenever I was turning the page, I must have accidentally grabbed two pages instead of one. And so after I like filled everything out, I went back to like look everything over and I realized that there was just two blank pages here. And I was trying to figure out something that could go here that would make sense. So I got this idea of having like a stats page from Books and Lala. Obviously, I don't have anything right now. I don't know what I want to track here. I'm just gonna come up with the categories later. Next, we have the yearly goals and a period tracker on this side of the page. I always like to make yearly goals so that I have something to strive towards throughout the year. They're less resolutions and more just things I want to accomplish. I also left a lot of room because I like to add on to this as the year goes by. There's stuff obviously that I know I want to accomplish at the beginning of the year, but then maybe like halfway through I decide, oh, I want to do this other thing, so I can just add it to the list. And then on this side obviously is a period tracker. I have the dates of the month down this side and then the months across like this. Whenever I was erasing my pencil, all the red smeared over here, which is really sad. But basically I just find this a useful tool to kind of visualize what's going on with all of that throughout the year. This is a spread that I just took straight out of my one from last year because I liked the way it was set up and I liked the way it worked, so don't fix what's not broken. The next spread we have is my writing goals for the year. This is a spread that I basically stole and kind of modified a little bit from one that Cattytastic had in her bullet journal. On the left side, there's basically an overview of my writing goals for the year. This is just a little bit more in detail than the ones that I have on my yearly goals list. And then below it, I have a word count tracker. Now, I use something similar to this to track word count for the draft that I was working on in 2018, and this really helped me keep track of my progress. This isn't gonna be for one specific project. This is just gonna be for my word count throughout the entire year, so I can just get an overview of how much I actually wrote during 2019. This last box is 145,000 words, and I do not think that I will reach it, but I figured counting by fives was just the easiest way to go, and that's just where it went, so we'll see how far I get on this. I highly doubt I will reach this last row like at all. And then the one on the right side is basically completely stolen from Caddytastic. Basically, it divides the year up into quarters so that I can divide out my goals into quarterly goals as well. I thought this was just a really good way to kind of divide up all of my goals so that it doesn't sound so overwhelming and impossible, and I can move stuff around if I need to later on. Next is my reading log for the year. This is pretty simple and straightforward. I just have the date that I finished the book, the title, the author, and then my rating. I also have it numbered down the sides, and I only numbered it by fives this time because I am sick and tired of writing all of these tiny numbers. I might go back in later and then fill in the in-between numbers, but for now, it's staying at five because your girl's hand is starting to hurt. But this goes to 75 books. I don't think I will get that far. My goal for the year is 52, which is all the way up here. If this was high school, I would 100% be able to make this number, but during the semester, I really don't get a ton of reading done. I know I can catch up over the summer and over winter breaks, but 52 seems like a fairly reachable goal for me, and so that's what I'm gonna go with for this year. 75, not so much. Now, this is one of my absolute favorite spreads simply for the aesthetic of it. These are two pages that I basically copied from my bullet journal last year. On the right, we have movies, so this is just gonna be a list of the movies that I watch in 2019 with the date, the title, and the director. And then just as some decoration, I had some little film strips at the top and the bottom, and then found this cool font on Pinterest that I decided to use last year, and I liked it so much that I used it again this year. And then on the right, obviously, is a list of TV shows as well. There's no date or whatever for this one because, you know, TV shows take forever to watch, and so this is just gonna be a place where I keep track of the shows that I'm watching, whether that's just a little bit of it or like every single season. I'll just keep a list here, and if I need to, just like have some more circles on the side and whatever. But yeah, I really like the design of both of these spreads. I think they're both really awesome. Next, I have a spread just to keep track of some YouTube stuff. Some of this was stolen also from Caddytastic, but basically this is just a place for me to write down video ideas. Now, other is kind of over here because obviously I'm gonna have a lot of bookish ideas because this is a BookTube channel, but the places are blank right now because I have a list on my phone of all of my video ideas, and so I was gonna go back in after this and fill in everything that I have so far right now onto the spread. And then over here, I have this little box thing again like I did for the writing spread. I don't really know exactly what I want to use this for yet. I've seen a lot of YouTubers that are doing bullet journal videos have like a subscriber count goal for the end of the year, but I don't know if I want to do that or not. I might just keep track of subscribers like as I hit different milestones, like every 5 or every 10. The stuff that Caddytastic had right here, I didn't really want to put in mine anyways, so I just put this here for now. We'll see what happens to it. Next, we have our first monthly spread, which I'm starting with December 2018 because there's some stuff I want to keep track of at the end of the year, and you know, it's my bullet journal. I can do whatever the heck I want to with it. Now, this spread has gone through so many changes during the sketching phase of me making this. First, I obviously have the monthly calendar, which is a little bit small and definitely different than what I did for my monthly spreads last year. This is like my bullet journal from last year, and as you can see, pretty much the entire page is just the monthly calendar so that I had room to write things like last day of classes, Mother's Day, first day of internship, and all that kind of stuff. And then I just had a little tiny thing for goals over here on the side, which that worked okay. But like I said before, I do use my calendar on my laptop for a lot of scheduling and keeping track of things. And so I found that I wasn't really using the monthly spread at all. It would come to the end of the month and I'd have to cross off like half of the month because I hadn't been using it, period. Even for the little goals list, like I wasn't looking at it enough. So I think this monthly spread layout is gonna work a lot better for me. I'm gonna put events and stuff on here. Like I'll keep track of like holidays, birthdays, and times that I'm traveling. And then underneath that, I have my monthly goals, which I have divided that into writing, books to be read, and videos to make. For writing, before I would have really vague goals for the month, and that really didn't help me accomplish much. So instead, I have a lot more concrete things that I want to finish by the end of the month. This right here is a lot of pre-planning stuff for another draft that I want to start working on next year. Books to be read, this is just going to be the top of my TBR for the month. I know I never get this many books done, but I have the spaces just so that I can look at what is the most important things for me to be reading. And then videos to make, obviously, are videos that I want to make during the month. And then on this side, I am actually kind of excited about keeping track of this. I realized as I was going through this that I had something to keep track of writing, I had something to keep track of YouTube stats or whatever, but I didn't really have anything besides my list of books read to keep track of what I was doing reading-wise. I kind of got this idea from Books in Lala's journal, where she would do a pages read graph chart thing, and then I added this like total down at the bottom so I can see the total number for the entire month. And then I just have what I read on the 3rd just as an example. Each dot represents 10, so I have 50, 100, 150, and 200 marked off. Most days I don't read more than 200, so that's the scale that I went for. And last but not least, we have the weekly spread. This spread is taken directly from Katty Tastic's video, and it is the main reason why I decided to give bullet journaling one more chance. Basically, my weeks before would just get so overcrowded with notes and things that I wanted to do, and it just looked so cluttered and it was hard to keep track of. I'll just go through and explain what every bit and piece does so that you can see why I think that this is gonna work for me a lot better than my spreads in the past. On the left, basically, we have three different sections: write, read, and film. And the idea is for me to put down the things within each category over here rather than listing it under the day of the week. This is just gonna keep the week a lot less cluttered, and I think this is a much more goal-oriented way of looking at the week. So right underneath write, I will put down the things that I want to accomplish writing-wise for the week, and then right next to it, there's a list of Sunday through Saturday where I can put those things on specific days and kind of plan out when I'm going to be doing things so that I know that I'll get all of these things done in the week. Next, we have reading, which these three little things are going to be the top of my TBR. I never finish more than this many books in a week, and if it is like a break where I'm going to be reading a ton, I can always add a couple more dots. And then next, we have film, which this isn't necessarily stuff that I'm filming this week, but it's stuff that I want to accomplish in the video realm. So the three videos that need to be on my radar for this week is my winter TBR, my Queen of Air and Darkness vlog, and my bullet journal video, which is this one right here. And then down here, we have just a little snapshot of the month with the week that we are in brackets. And then in this little corner right here is blank right now. I still haven't finalized what I want to put here. Katty Tastic has a habit tracker here, which I think I'm gonna do that. I just don't know what habits I want to track yet. And then on the right side of the page, this is the main section of the weekly spread, obviously. It has the dates of the week down on the side, and then the days and the date underneath it again. Basically, here's gonna be everything that I'm doing that week minus the writing, reading, and filming stuff. There's gonna be a lot of important dates for school on here, not necessarily individual assignments, because otherwise this would get way too crowded and I would not have enough room, but I will put in important dates. Like right here, I have my editing final, and then like Wednesday, I have like laundry and chores that I need to get done. Friday, I'm leaving to fly home, and then I have like packing and unpacking like surrounding that. I've come to realize that bullet journals for me are less to-do lists and more goal-oriented things. And I feel like this kind of layout is much more goal-oriented. I know that some of this, especially the monthly and weekly, is gonna tweak and change a little bit as I go along so that I can find what fits for me best. And then I'll just keep this little ribbon on the week that I'm in, so that I can easily flip to that. But that is all. That is my bullet journal for 2019 in the setup. I hope that you enjoyed this video. I'll just quickly flip through as I am wrapping this up. But thank you so much for watching. I am very excited to see where this journal goes. I'm hoping that this is a much better way for me to keep track of everything. There's a lot less clutter and a lot more stuff that I feel like I'm actually gonna use. I might do updates throughout the year. I don't think I'm going to do monthly bullet journal videos, because I just, between this and this, there's not enough for an entire video. I don't know how to do my outro like this, because I can't, like, can I wave like this? Does that look weird? I feel like it probably does. Oh, here we go. This is how we're gonna do it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon. Bye.